So we've got our palm tree just here, our palm tree trunk. And what we're going to do now is we're going to make the leaves to go with the tree. So to do that, what we're going to do is we're going to start by going to add mesh plane. Okay, and what I'm going to do, I'm just going to scale this quickly. So it's kind of like a big long plank, basically. And this is going to be the length of your leaf. So if you think of a palm tree leaf, we want it to be quite long. Okay, and I'm just going to go to move, and I'm just going to move that out the way of the tree. Okay, maybe that's a bit long, actually. I might just scale that inwards a touch, maybe like that. Okay, cool. Then just position your camera so you can kind of see it. Okay, I'm going to use the pan tool and zoom tool and so on, just to get it roughly in the middle of my screen. Okay, now once we've done this, we're going to have to make the shape of the leaf. So we're going to go into edit mode, okay, because we want to edit this particular block here, and this time we're going to use the knife. Okay, and this will allow us to cut a shape in our sort of plank here. So I'm just going to go ahead and just kind of very roughly draw a sort of shape of a palm tree leaf. Okay, I'm doing this very quickly, so I'm sure you guys do a much better job than this. So something a little bit like this, maybe. Like I say, it's a bit of a rush job, but never mind. So the idea of this is we're going to make a shape and then we're going to cut the bits out that we don't need. Okay, it's a terrible palm tree, but never mind. We'll go with it. So maybe something like that. Okay, and then we've still got the knife tool selected. Just press enter. Okay, and that will get rid of it. And we're left with our leaf. Okay. So what we need to do now is get rid of these bits that we don't want. All right, so I'm going to go on the select tool, and a bit like we've done in the past, I'm just going to hold down shift. I'm just going to select the areas we want to delete. Okay, just like that. So a bit like if you're cutting a leaf out of a sheet of paper, similar idea. And once we've got them all selected, press X to delete them, and you want to be clicking on faces. Okay, faces on that menu. Oops. Selected. I've inversely selected it. Okay, now my mistake there is the original leaf was already selected, so I am going to undo that. Sorry, redo. There we go. Just going to click outside. That was my mistake. I had everything selected, so I'm just going to very quickly do that again. This is the benefit of Control Z. Okay, we can undo any mistakes that we make. So select with shift held down. X to delete and faces, and this time we have a nice leaf. Okay, all right, good. So next step here is we want to add a little bit of some realism to the leaf, because obviously it's a little bit flat at the moment. So we're going to go back to the knife tool, just to sort of what I explained by flat is literally it's like that, it's just flat like a bit of paper, and obviously leaves aren't like that, they're sort of bent and curved and all kinds of things. So we're going to go back to the knife tool just here, and I'm just going to do a load of sort of crisscrosses on the leaf. Okay, so like there to there, and then enter, and like there to there. Okay, I'm just pressing enter after I've done each one of these sort of crisscrosses, because I don't want it to go like zigzaggy. You just want to create something a bit like almost like a sort of grid with lots of sections of the leaf in. Okay, now you don't have to be massively accurate here, as you can see, just kind of draw a few squares across like so. Okay, and I'm just going to draw maybe like one here to here. Now the purpose, like the reason we're doing this, is because we're going to use the tool we used last time, which gave us that kind of organic style waviness. Okay, so the way we're going to do this is we'll make sure up here, if you remember the proportional editing tool, just make sure that's selected. and just make sure you're in the faces select mode up here. Okay, and what we're going to do is we're going to just click on one of these panes in the middle. It doesn't necessarily matter which one, and I'm going to hit the move tool, and I'm going to move it downwards. Okay, now if I just sort of rotate around, you can see it's kind of curving. Okay, it's giving that some curve element here. So I'm just going to move that. And remember, we've got the mouse wheel we can use to kind of increase the strength or decrease the strength of the curve. So I'm going to kind of do something roughly maybe about that. Let's have a look. That looks all right. Okay, good. Now, once I've done that, what we're going to do is we're going to duplicate the leaf. Okay, so I'm just going to kind of click out of that, and we're just going to go back to object mode. Okay, and I'm just going to select it, and we're just going to go to use Shift and D to duplicate. Okay, so Shift, every time you duplicate, Shift and B, and you stick a new one to your cursor. You can just click and put it down. So we've got four leaves now. Now what we can do from here is we can then put them on the palm tree. Okay, so we can use a combination of rotate, move, and so on, just to kind of get them in roughly the right place, all right? So I won't do the whole thing because it will take a little while here, but we have to use our combination, a bit like we've done before, of like the camera, to make sure we just get things in roughly the right place. Okay, so let's see. Yeah, there we go. So I won't do all of them, like I say, because it will take a long time, but I'm just going to do one very, very roughly. You'll have a bit more time to do this yourself. Okay, so you can see I'm just changing the angles of everything to get like a top-down view, sideways view, and so on. I've kind of done this, you can see it looks, so if we rotate on the green, there we go, and we get something a bit like that maybe, and then we can always play around with the rotation a little bit, have it facing downwards a bit, and I'm just going to move that down a touch again, something a bit like that. Okay, and then if you then go and attach the other three palm trees, okay, and then once you've done that, we can then color them in. Okay, I'm sure you remember how to do that from the previous videos, but remember to go into the rendered mode up here. Okay, and then you can use down here, we can add the different colors by clicking there and then going kind of as we've done before. Okay, all right, but I won't go through all of that, you can do that yourself. So make a good color for the leaves, for the trunk. Okay, you could add some like coconuts, maybe you could add some sand and see around it and so on. But if you go ahead and get that tree finished up so it looks reasonably as kind of realistic as we can make it,